Welcome back to the Lady Lauren Show. We're super excited to be back this week with special guests. We have Queen Stacie with us, and Hunter he's here too, but like who cares?
Not me.
No, we love Hunter.
We love Hunter too, but like
But Momma
Stacie's here,
Stacie's
so
here.
just getting my audio now.
Hunter quitting.
If you guys don't know who Momma Stacie is the mom of Hunter, one of our understudies. And Stacie has slowly become, actually, no, you pretty much adopted us the second you found out about us, which has
Pretty
been
much.
literally so much fun. I cannot even describe how much fun it is to have you around. And she really likes Disney and she wanted to be on the podcast, as she should, you know. So we have an episode just for Disney alone so that Stacie can talk about Disney. And we all love Disney.
It's all my
So,
fault.
no, it's not your fault because now we have an excuse to talk about Disney just
Okay,
in
good.
general.
Yeah.
So, I'm excited. I'm really excited. Why do you
Me
like,
too.
why, I have to ask you, like, why do you like Disney so much?
You know, I was born in Arizona, which is obviously right next to California. So growing up, we went to Disneyland all the time. And just the magic of it and the just everything about it. It was just like the coolest thing. And to go as much as I was able to go, I was very, very fortunate to do that. And just kind of grew on me. And then when Hunter and his younger brother were little, I got to work at the Disney store at our local mall here in Tulsa. And that's when I really, really fell in love with Disney. That I had a manager that every Disney was an adjective, you're being so Disney or this is so Disney, and she really kind of sparked even more of an interest for me. She actually now works down, she transferred from our store to work down at Disney World and started out at Mouse Gears. And then from there, she transferred into Epcot, and she was part of guest services. And she just kind of bounced around everywhere. And then with the pandemic, she was actually one of those that was laid off. Like she, when before the pandemic, like right before that happened, I think she hit her 25-year anniversary.
Wow.
And with the, oh gosh, what was his name, Hunter? You know, the guy who went literally knocked on her door in Florida. The president CEO
Josh
guy. Yes. What's his last name?
tomorrow
Yes, Josh D'Amaro
the guy who
showed
should
up
be
in her
CEO
front
and not Bob.
door. And yeah, the story that she has on Facebook where he showed up her house with like this huge award and the funny thing was she said the dog peed a little bit and on the floor, but she didn't even care. I mean, the whole story is hilarious, but she's actually married to the bass player for REO Speedwagon. So that's, they kind of have a house in Florida. And
It's not fair.
I know, right?
How many times
So
have they gotten to meet Mark Hamill?
many, multiple times. Like
It's not
they're
fair.
friends with Mark, they're friends with,
Friends with him.
yeah, Larry the Cable Guy. Like,
Oh
yeah,
my gosh,
I mean, when you're married to a rock star, you get to meet a lot of cool people. So they've done a lot of
not
charity
fair.
work with Larry the Cable Guy. But yeah, when Star Wars, when Galaxy's Edge opened down in Florida, she got to go. And of course, hobnob and rub elbows with Mark and all the others. I say Mark like I know him too, Mr. Hamill. But yeah, so it was pretty cool. But she's really the one who started my look. Let's call it an obsession.
Obsession.
It is an obsession. My very first tattoo was Mickey. My second tattoo was Mickey. Actually, my second tattoo, I don't know if you can see it, but these are the coordinates for Disneyland. And
Oh
then
my gosh.
I had to twist my arm around, but it has Mickey here on the side. So if you were to plug these coordinates into a what do
GPS?
you call it? Yeah,
Map.
GPS. it map. Would the pin would literally land right in the middle of Anaheim, just because I'm more mm-hmm. that from the nostalgia purposes, just of being there growing up and stuff. But I mean, I love World too. World is crazy fun.
I mean, yeah,
I feel a little question. I feel like I'm probably definitely outnumbered on the Disney World side here
deserved
tonight. No.
You guys just have flight of passage, okay?
We have 4 parks, 2 water parks, and like 30 hotels. Thank you.
Well,
true.
So
yeah.
But the thing that's special to me about Land is the fact that Walt actually walked those streets. Mm. You know, he passed away before even Magic Kingdom opened 50 years ago. And you know, that's what I think I like most about Disneyland over World, but I do love them both.
Mm-hmm. I've never been to Disneyland, which like, I need to go. I'm working on it.
We're going to try, you guys can come too, but the Lady
Thank Long you. I was going to come anyway.
Yeah.
Whether you were invited or not.
You guys should all come and we should all meet at Disneyland, because both Kenzie and Izzy haven't gone to Disneyland before. So it would be kind of
then maybe Afton can meet up with us too.
Yes, we can get Afton there.
She lives down there. Yeah.
Oh my gosh, that would be so cool if we had everyone. We all went to Disneyland.
That would be
together.
Fun. That would be really fun.
So do you consider Disneyland better than Disney World? Like, if you were going to go on vacation, would you go to Disney World or Disneyland?
Land.
Really?
Yes. And because of the fact of just, you know, growing up there and because it's the original, you know, and I just have so many memories there. And if it hadn't been for COVID and the restrictions in California, that's where we would have gone for my big birthday. Oh, and then really? I would have never met Kenzie. So there was a couple of that came out of the world. I got to meet Kenzie and, you know, so.
Disney World is better because it has me and Izzy.
That's a little biased, but it is what it is, I guess.
But yes, if I had my preference, and like I said, I really wanted to go to Land for my birthday, but I mean, that had been my plan for 2 or 3 years to go for this particular number. We're not going to say how old I turned. But
21.
There you go. My big 21st birthday. Ooh. Or my quarter of a century.
Let's go out.
Why am I older than my mother?
I don't know, Hunter. Mind your own business.
Okay. Right.
Sorry. I invited him.
But I do have to ask though, because everyone like has a specific land that they love the most out of like either not like inside each park. So like you have like Cars Land or like Pixar's Pier or, you know, Galaxy's Edge. Out of like both Disney World and Disneyland, what is your favorite like land or area?
I would have to say it's a toss up between Fantasyland and Tomorrowland.
Good ones.
Yeah.
Classics.
Because, you know, Tomorrowland is very futuristic. You've got all of the, you know, Space Mountain and the Star Tours and all of that. But then Fantasyland kind of also brings back the nostalgia and takes you to, you know, the original movie or, you know, the original cartoon movies like, you know, Dumbo and, you know, Fantasmic and things like that. So just little elements.
They're both really good.
Those are my top two.
Really?
Are they really?
Yeah, because like same thing like with like Fantasyland, because like I remember being a kid and like trying to pull the sword out of the stone in front of the carousel and riding the carousel. I literally went on the carousel on my 16th birthday, and it was my first time back at Disney in a few years, and we saw Wishes, and then I cried on the carousel. I was like so sad because I was like 16, I was in high school, and I grew up like 2 hours away from Disney World. So I went like a lot growing up, but not like we went like maybe once a year. So then when I was 16, I hadn't been in a couple of years. We had taken a break, and I was just like, I just love it here so much. And I want to be here all the time. Mm-hmm. And like, when I think about it now, like it makes me so like happy that like I moved here and this is my life now, because that's like what I really wanted then. But yeah. And then Carousel of Progress is my controversial favorite ride.
That's a good ride.
Yes.
So that's like why I love Tomorrowland, because I love that ride and I love Space Mountain.
Yes. But you get that song stuck in your head.
Yes, yes. But it's worth it in the long run. Great music.
Okay, that's enough, Hunter.
Just that way.
Hunter, do you want to produce our new theme song?
Yeah, do you want to do a theme song? We could do like a little Disney
segment.
It's
going to be strictly drums, though, because that's all I can play.
That is
all we need.
So.
Like, that's so... It's so interesting to me that you guys love those lands, because I loved Adventureland because I grew up like very like Western and like a Western environment. And like my grandparents are from like out in the country, Phoenix, where we like lived in, like with the, all the cacti and like,
but shouldn't you like little... Frontierland?
Yeah.
Yeah. But okay. Here's the thing. Adventureland has good rides, okay? And so it was
Jones.
Like I was there.
I know you did not just slander country bears.
Oh my gosh, you guys
deserved it.
Let me tell you a story about country bears. Growing up, that ride or that show just like I'm traumatized forever.
They're scary
because they're talking on the walls. Well, I had it, my great uncle, he was a hunter, and so his house, like he had this one room that had deer all the way around. I wouldn't go in it because I was afraid they were going to start talking to me. Oh, it scared me so bad. So bad.
My gosh. I remember watching it for the first time and I didn't know what was going to happen, and then they all just like started like moving and talking, and it literally threw me off. And then they walk around outside.
Yeah,
yes.
Like, creepy.
I don't like walk around characters. I'll go see the show once in a while when I want some like air conditioning and I want like sit
there
down.
You go.
But like
just sit down for a minute.
Walk around characters, I'm like, don't make eye contact.
Nope.
Don't look at me,
please.
Keep going.
But I do have to ask, like, what is your favorite ride in the parks?
Oof. Well, up until my latest trip, it was probably Space Mountain.
Ooh, okay.
But Flight of Passage is incredible. We were fortunate enough because, you know, there was obviously restrictions on, you know, how many people were in the park, so that there was like no lines.
Mm-hmm.
And we got to ride it twice. It was just like, oh my gosh. Yeah.
I've still only been on like a handful of times just because the line is long. But the first time I rode it, I think we waited like 2.5-3 hours, which is a very long time to wait for a ride. And perfect. I'm like, if you've ever been to the parks with me, the wait's more than 30 minutes.
Oh
I'm
my
like,
gosh.
I'm like, I don't really want to do it. I got better.
She's a little impatient.
She is.
I'm
say
sorry.
She's short on impatience.
I don't. Hey. Yeah, I just don't like to wait in lines. I go all the time. I don't really want to like, I have an annual pass, right? Like, I don't need to go all the time. I don't need to wait all that line, whatever. But we waited like
the two are rubbing it in. I
know.
Have an annual pass.
We waited like 2 hours, and usually I'm like mad, but we like got off that ride and I was like, it was worth every second.
I think that's what a lot of people say, you know. That's what I've heard. You know, I waited. I mean, people we were standing in line with, even when we were having to stand in line, because the second time we rode it, we had my dad with me, and he happened to have a motorized wheelchair because he has a knee issue. And so anyway, totally different side story there, but we told him you've got to try it. So because he was in a wheelchair, they gave us a designated time to go back. And when we went, but so the first time we were standing in line, and you guys didn't go with us to that, did you, Izzy? You guys were just at the other park with us. Although they were there, but they never met up with
Izzy
us,
was there, but she just Izzy was followed
there.
Us around.
Yeah, Izzy was there, but anyway, the people that we were standing in line with the first time, they were like, yeah, the first time I ever rode this, I waited 5 hours. I wouldn't wait 5 hours for a ride.
No.
Especially if you're coming from out of state and you only have one day at that park, I'm not going to waste half of my day staying in line for one ride, you know? Mm-hmm. So we were very fortunate when we went to not have waited that long. And the second time we literally walked in, there was nobody in front of us.
Yeah. So. I sadly still have never been to Animal Kingdom. And I thought I was going to go this summer.
It's all right. But
I know. That's what people are saying. Like, it's definitely, it just.
Flight of Passage saved it for me.
I know. I mean, I love Avatar. So I was really like wanting to go on a Flight of Passage, but like spending that much money to go on the park. And like, I have the San Diego Zoo and Safari Park. So that's like, it's kind of hard to top when it comes to like seeing the safari aspect of like Animal Kingdom. So like my family personally like never went to Animal Kingdom, but I wanted to go specifically for Flight of Passage.
Animal Kingdom is one of my favorite parks, actually.
Really?
Yeah. Like Magic Kingdom is my favorite, and then Animal Kingdom, and then Hollywood Studios.
Really?
And then Epcot. Yeah, like I used to not appreciate Animal Kingdom as much. And I definitely appreciate it more when it's not 95 degrees outside. Because Animal Kingdom, anyone who like is from here will tell you that Animal Kingdom is the hottest park. There's no comparison. Well, it depends on the day, like that or Epcot, because if it's like a sunshiny day, Epcot is hotter because there's no shade. But if it's a rainy day, Animal Kingdom is hotter because it's so humid and all the plants trap the humidity. But I like Animal Kingdom has like just such a great backstory. And Joe Rohde, who's like the guy who created Animal Kingdom, like every single like aspect of that park was so well thought out.
Very intentional.
Yeah. And so like, I appreciate that so much. Like that's a part of Disney I just love that I'll never be able to get over is how much detail Disney puts into everything in the park.
Yes.
Animal Kingdom is such a good example of that. And Everest is one of my favorite rides. So.
Oh yeah. How many times did you do that one, Hunter? Did we do that one three times?
We did it three times that day.
Yeah. That was crazy.
Wow. How many rides does like bigger rides does Animal Kingdom have?
Well, it has one of the best rides in Disney.
Yeah.
Dinosaur.
Oh.
I don't think that's what Hunter was thinking.
Dinosaur is a little janky now.
Hey.
Hey, no, someone had their flash on and I saw the mechanics under one of the dinosaurs. Like, oh, well, there it is.
I have never been to Disneyland. Isn't Indiana Jones like very similar to Dinosaur?
It's the same system.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Same vehicle.
Although for some reason I was thinking that it was like, what did I say?
You thought it was like Small World.
I kept telling my mom, oh, it's just like Small World. You just get in this little boat and just kind of ride around and
not at all.
And we got there and I was like, there's no boat.
I made Izzy go on Dinosaur yesterday. I was like, the line's only 10 minutes. We gotta go. I love that ride. I don't care what anyone says.
It can use an update though.
So obviously you have like the original rides on at both Disneyland and at Disney World, but what has been your favorite ride that's been like a newer addition to the parks?
Both parks.
Sure.
Like Land and World.
Sure.
I would have to say Rise.
Yeah.
Rise of the Resistance. And that one, boy, that's the thing is between Rise and Pandora, it's like, how do you choose? You like them both for different reasons, you know? But I mean, I really, really enjoyed Rise of the Resistance.
Yeah. Have you been to Disneyland since Galaxy's Edge was opened?
Yes. So we went in 2019 in November for Hunter's birthday.
Okay.
Guy's 26th birthday, because that's where he wanted to go. He said, I want to go to Disneyland, to Galaxy's Edge. So thank God we did it then. Otherwise we would have been totally
I was gonna go by myself because they're like, we won't have money. I'm like, okay, I'll just go by myself and I don't care. Okay.
The Rise of the Resistance was not open yet though.
When
I was very mad.
It was just Galaxy or Smuggler's Run.
Mm-hmm.
But so when, you know, we did the whole lightsaber thing, which Hunter's buddy who came with us did. He's an Apple genius, like truly works for Apple and he's one of their geniuses.
Whoa.
He does a lot of editing and stuff. And he put this whole video together like 10 minutes, I think it was, something of Hunter like and his brother like building their lightsabers. So we did that. And then I built a little droid that's like the colors of Mickey Mouse. So it's like red and black. And but he's like the R2 unit.
I want one of the BB ones so bad. And there's a girl I found on Instagram who paints them pink. Oh. And everyone,
they don't have pink, do they? They just have like a purplish.
They only have a couple
kind of silly.
She paints them pink and they look so good. And I want one so bad because I wanted a droid since Galaxy's Edge like started doing that. But I was always like, but like I'm not like obsessed with the colors. Like I would probably just build an all black one because like pink or black is like my colors. That's like it. And I was like, I don't really want to like spend the money. And then I found this girl. So I'm like kind of just waiting to, because like you buy it. You can either like buy it yourself from Galaxy's Edge and she'll like send it to her and she'll paint it. Or you can like buy one from her because I guess she just goes to Galaxy's Edge a lot and like buys a bunch of them to
must
paint.
Be nice.
I know. I'm like, I don't know how got the budget for that, but I highly recommend if you want. She makes like other ones too. So shout out to our audience if you want like a cute droid. Her Instagram is like Adora Droids and
hashtag ad.
That should be one of our. That can be one our creator for this episode.
Yeah. Awesome. That'll be for the episode.
Yeah. She makes a bunch of ones. She did like a teal one recently. It was really cute. I don't know. I just like it. I have to be different.
Well, I have a question about that because a lot of people, of course, when it first was released that you can build a lightsaber and a droid, everyone was like going like nuts about it because it's like really exciting. But of the people that I've met that have done it, like a lot of them regret the decision and they said that they would either rather like, or like at least for not for the droid because the droid's like more unique, you can't really like make a droid that way, but for the lightsaber itself, a lot of people that I have talked to have said that they kind of regret the decision because it wasn't exactly the experience they thought they were getting and the lightsaber isn't as good quality as they wanted it to be and that they would rather like just buy one of the legacy sabers. So do you guys feel the same way or do you feel like it's like a you must do type thing?
Do you want a secret?
Yes.
Do both.
Okay.
Buy the legacy and build your own. It's just money.
For build your own, I think what you're paying for is the experience.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
And I don't know if you've watched a video or if you've actually gone with somebody who's made one, but that person who walks you through all of those steps, they're like total actor, actress. I mean, they know they have a whole script they have to follow. And it just, I think that's what made it so cool. I was just observing, you know.
Yeah.
But it was just really neat how, you know, they kind of, there's a whole music sound. Literally from the time you walk in until you walk out, it's a whole score of music behind you, and the lights dim, and they, you know, and then they get brighter, and at one point, spoiler, Yoda talks to you, you know. Aww. And it's just really, really neat. I thought that was the part of it that I liked the most, you know. The building, it wasn't that big of a deal. I like the fact that you have several different options to build, you know. And so Hunter and Logan, you know, they both got a different one and different crystals. But for me, that's what I was actually kind of disappointed in, the whole droid thing, but building that. But, you know, because it was just go in, grab your parts, go put it together, you know. It's like 5-10 minutes, whereas the whole lightsaber thing is a full-on immersive experience. You know,
I've definitely seen videos of both of them and the droid one seems like way more hectic than the lightsaber one.
Yeah,
I think the droid one is like definitely more just like anyone really can do, I guess. You know what I mean? Like, not that kids can't do like the lightsaber experience, but I feel like the lightsaber experience is definitely more geared towards like adults who are like lifelong fans and stuff like that.
I will say this, if I had a young child who wanted to do it, I would tell them know, just because they're not going to appreciate the experience like say Hunter did when he was doing his.
I would really like to go with someone who's doing it, just like to see what's going on, because like personally I'm just not a fan of like the way the lightsabers themselves look. Like I just don't want to spend the money to like,
they're really chunky and heavy.
Yeah, that's my thing, is they're really like like, has I have a like some friends who have them here that I've like seen and like gotten to hold and like look at, and they're just like quite large, and I have so many already, like legacy sabers, like do I really need another? So I would love to go with someone who, like one of my friends who's doing it, and observe.
Yeah.
And just
now let me ask you a question. I don't know much about the legacy ones, but do they have crystals that you can interchange?
No.
It's just what you buy is what you get.
Yeah, the only one so far they have that can change color for the legacy is just the Ahsoka ones have the color changing button from Clone Wars. But which is really cool. I like having that because I have the ones, best purchase I've ever made.
I'm still mad they didn't have them when we went.
Yeah,
those are the ones I wanted.
They've been out of a lot of stuff lately.
Yeah.
Come on, just make it.
It's not that hard.
Literally, get it together. Honestly.
Come on, Disney.
It's
stupid mouse.
No, Hunter, take it back.
Oh, those are fighting words.
He's gone.
You're gonna wake up to them in the middle of the night, and Mickey Mouse is gonna be standing over you.
Pal,
what did you say?
Yeah, exactly.
Make more lightsabers. What I said.
Oh, when I stayed in Florida for a couple of weeks, and when I went there, I was like, I'm gonna get the Kenobi saber, and I was really excited about it because it's like the one saber that's always there. Like not like
it was there when I was there.
Yes, it literally was.
And a week after you.
I know.
With us that day, you could have gotten it.
When you guys were leaving, when you guys were literally flying out, I was driving into the state, and I felt really bad about it. But anyways,
sounds
they didn't
like
have
a personal problem.
Yeah, I know. They didn't have Kenobi Saber, and I was really sad about
it. That's okay. Hunter will be back in September.
Oh, September.
So Hunter will be back in September.
I will.
Are you kicking
well? I guess
we're going again.
Not we, you and your father.
Oh,
remember?
Oh,
for those of you who don't know, Hunter's grandparents, who are my parents, are retiring to Florida.
Dang. You get to go stay your grandparents and
help them move.
Hey, maybe Izzy can let me in and I can just go grab the lightsaber and leave.
There you go,
if they have them.
Yeah, you could.
Can you hear that, Izzy? Are you watching this right now?
If she's not blocked out of the park.
Help me out, please.
She's probably at the park. Literally right now.
Let's look at the Snapchat.
Definitely there right now.
Yeah.
No, she was driving home earlier, remember?
Oh, yeah.
I don't remember.
Always complaining about her drive home. Her life is so...
She was there yesterday.
Oh, my goodness.
And so are you. Never mind.
Yeah. I also have to ask, what is your favorite Disney character?
That's a dumb question.
Wait, do we have to ask that? Can you see him?
He's right there.
Come on, let me.
I can't walk 2 feet. I can't walk 2 feet in this house and not see him.
He's everywhere.
Do you have like a specific show or like appearance that he makes digital, like online, like Disney material, or like in the parks? Do you have something that you like to see him specifically at?
No, just anytime I see him, I just
good time.
I turn into a little giggly child again.
Just want to hug him again.
Like I wave at him when he goes by in a parade.
Oh,
I literally talk about all the time. I was literally talking to Izzy about this yesterday because we were at Disney yesterday, and I was like,
not fair.
I just wish the last time I hugged Mickey Mouse, I knew it was the last time.
Okay, don't do this right now.
Because like, I used to before COVID, sorry to flex, but I was going like twice a week to Disney before COVID. Because I go to school, my college is like 10 minutes away from Disney, and I live like 30 minutes away from my school. So I was like, oh, well, I'm already spending the gas to come out here. Might as well just go to Disney while I'm here. Doing that all the time. And then COVID happened. Then I hadn't been to Disney in months. And I was like, I'm so sad. Like, I just want to hug Mickey Mouse again. Like, I cannot wait. I don't care how old I am. Character meet and greets are like my favorite thing ever. Mm-hmm. It makes me feel like I'm a kid again, and I don't care how old I am, I'm gonna be like in line for meet and greets for the rest of my life. I don't care. I can't wait till I have kids though, so it doesn't look weird.
this isn't for my kids, it's for me.
Exactly. I don't care if you don't want to meet Mickey Mouse or meeting him today.
Meeting him.
Stop crying.
Exactly.
Shut up.
I don't know. The thing is I don't know when meet and greets are going to come back.
We don't know.
Yeah, I know. I don't want to.
I know. I'm really sad about it.
Let's not discuss the realities of the world. Anyway, I can't do it.
Yeah, we're on a happy topic.
Okay,
yeah.
Sorry.
Not the sad stuff.
Be quiet.
I want character dining back. That's what I love. I love.
Yes.
You want overpriced plastic food?
Hey, Mickey waffles slap. Mickey? I don't care what anyone.
Those are the only things that are good.
No, there's plenty.
I could eat those all day and not just. Done. Gluttony does not count with that. I'm sure it's not a sin right there.
For the Mickey waffle, anything?
Yeah, if it has Mickey, it doesn't count towards the gluttony thing.
Yeah, no, I miss character dining. Although I do like how they're doing so, like. Before, a lot of the character dining restaurants at Disney were like buffet style. I'm not gonna lie, buffet restaurants have always kind of freaked me out. I don't like other people touching my food. It just makes me a little uncomfortable. So even before all of this, like I don't want to be like I'm a germaphobe, but like I am, and I don't want no one breathing on my stuff. And now they kind of do like all of those restaurants, instead of being buffet style, they're like family style. So they bring like a tray of food to your table. And I am like way more on board with that. So they can keep that. Just bring back Mickey. Like,
that's cool.
True.
Yeah. It's like they'll bring you like a tray, and then like, you can like, you got like your party gets to like pull off the tray or whatever. And you can ask them like, say like,
just give me a tray of pancakes just for me.
Well, you can ask too. That's like a thing. Like, you can, when the waiter comes back by, you can be like, hey, like, can you bring us more Mickey waffles? And they'll bring it like no extra cost.
Give it to me.
It's still like per person and not like per item. So it's just like buffet, but without having to like everyone in the whole restaurant digging out of the same.
It's your own personal buffet.
Yeah.
Right. At your table.
Makes sense. I'm definitely more of a fan of that, of like the family style.
Okay, so I've never stayed in a Disney World hotel either. So is that like what all the Disney World hotels' breakfasts are like? Or
no.
Most of the hotels just have like, well, not most, the value resorts and like the moderate resorts all have usually like a food court type of situation in them. Mm-hmm. Or like a very casual cheap dining situation where it's just like you just go get your food, sit down, whatever. But a lot of the restaurants like Ohana Polynesian, they're mm-hmm. like more like restaurants. The Crystal Palace in Magic Kingdom, that one has like Pooh and Friends. I've done that one a few times. Mm-hmm. It's really fun. Ohana has like Mickey and Minnie and like all of them, and they're in like Hawaiian clothes, and Lilo and Stitch are there. I did one for my birthday 2019. My last character dining, I think I did, was it's called Cape May Cafe. It's at the same place we got ice cream at when you were here.
Okay, yeah.
That same resort. And so they were all in beach clothes.
That's
super cute. So they like dress themed to whatever the restaurant is. But it's like, it can be pricey. I think it was like $40 a person. But again, they're like buffet style. So it's like, I'm over here. I'm like, I'm eating as much as $40 is worth. I don't care.
Not all day specifically for that.
Yes.
But like, I only ever do it for like special, like my birthday or whatever.
Yeah.
So that's what they're for. I mean, they're for, I don't know if they're necessarily for like a girl going for her 20th birthday, yeah. But whatever. They have them. They're like kind of starting it again, but like not really. Like they have like Mickey and Minnie in them, and they'll like walk around the restaurant, but they like won't get close to you to take
pictures. I've seen some videos of that. Yeah.
You can like take a picture with them from like they're standing 10 feet behind you, but that's about it.
Yes. I saw a really sweet video of he was like a young adult, and I think he maybe had like cerebral palsy or something. He was in a wheelchair. And he just went crazy. Mickey came around the corner and he was just like, and he started clapping and waving. And so I'm glad that at least they're doing something like that so that, people can enjoy a little bit of the magic.
I saw Mickey in Epcot like 2 months ago. They were in the Garden Grill restaurant, which is in like the building that Soarin's in, wasn't open at the time. I don't know. But they were walking around in there. And so like when you were walking by, you could see them. And I was just like, I love you, Mickey. Like, I miss you.
Oh my gosh. I feel that. Well, because at Disneyland, they have less areas to like meet characters. A lot of them just like walk around and you happen to be there when they're like walking through the park. And like Tiana, Princess Tiana is my favorite character ever. Oops. And so... Don't even, Hunter.
You finally watched it, didn't you?
The Queen. You watched The Princess and the Frog, right?
I fell asleep in it.
Honestly, I should kick you.
I didn't. I didn't fall asleep.
I'll kick him for you.
It was good. I liked it.
I'm glad. But anyways, I saw her, like, that was, like, the one thing that I had to do every time I was at Disney, like, in high school, was be at the area where Tiana would be when she would walk through, and I would always, like, walk with her, and I'd be like, hi, how are you? And, like, I'm really sad that I can't, like, see her anymore, but when I went, before I left Florida, we went one last time to Disney World, and I saw her in the parade, and I was like, hi, and she's like, hi, and I was like, okay, I'm good. For another year. Aww. I can last.
I'm definitely jealous of Disneyland for that, like having the characters like walk around. Because I know that like when I was a kid, like I vividly remember like that used to be more common at Disney World was the characters walking around. Mm-hmm. But just as like time has gone on, they've like stopped that. Mainly Disney World is obviously just like a lot busier than Disneyland and a lot bigger. Mm-hmm. And I mean, I've seen it at Galaxy's Edge when they have the walk around characters. Like crowds just form around them and it's so like they can't really walk around because people, I feel like at Disneyland, because like people always say Disneyland is built for locals and Disney World is built for people coming on vacation. And I think that's like,
I believe that.
Yeah. I think the people at Disneyland like know to not do that, I guess. I mean, obviously there's a tourist at Disneyland too, but it's just not the same as the environment at Disney World.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I wish we could have it more, but like I understand that it's really just like it wouldn't be effective
for
them to do it that way at Disney World.
Yeah, and Disney does a good job at it too at Disneyland because especially, well, I think they switched up the schedules depending on the season because in winter she would walk around, but during like summer she would be on like the boat that would go around the island. Mm-hmm. And she would only stay on there. So, like, during winter when it's less crowded, she would walk around. And they're really good at keeping them moving because people will, like, try to stop them and, like, take pictures.
Yeah.
Like that, and they're just, like, completely ignoring them and keep on walking just so they don't stop, which is really good. But I think Disney World is just, like, it's so crazy. Like, even, like, when I, like, during COVID, like, it's still, like, crazy how like people are and people just think that they can like stop characters and like do whatever they want there and more like Disneyland people are like more like okay
weird
it's weird.
I mean
it's a different breed.
I spent a lot of time being a Galaxy's Edge groupie last year before COVID ended the world and like I would see the same people there every
testing
day
my patience
following Kylo Ren around. I was one of them, yes, but I like kept my distance and like left him alone.
Respect.
There was people who were like actively like being a little aggressive and I was like, first of all, you don't even know who's in you don't know who he's friends with. there's someone in there. Don't hurt their feelings.
There you go. There you go.
Character integrity.
Kylo has feelings.
Yeah. Don't work for him yet.
So.
You don't even work for him. Why are you saying that?
Because what if we have like, what if an 8-year-old clicks on this video? I don't want to ruin their lives.
The 8-year-old watching is like, what do they mean?
Start them young.
Stop. I can't believe.
I mean, Disney's really good at keeping the magic. Let me tell you, they know how to snipe people if the magic is not kept. So. Oh, yeah.
We'll just cut those whole last 2 minutes out then.
No. We read over their heads, hopefully.
Anyways.
I mean, it went over my head. I'm not sure what we were talking about, but.
Okay. That's all.
What were you saying?
Nothing.
Well, I wasn't listening. What?
Kylo Ren. Amazing. Okay.
Who's that?
I just have my stacks and stacks and stacks of.
Oh, don't even show
oh
up.
Oh my gosh. How rude. Is there a way we can like delete her?
Wait, I got. Hold on.
Yes, there is. Anything for you, Mom.
Uh-oh. Hunter's going to get something.
Oh my gosh, Kenzie, how many years have you been a pass holder?
Since 2016.
Oh, wow.
I was 16. That was what I was, instead of, you know, having bills and responsibilities at 16, I was just paying my Disney pass.
I mean, I will admit, when I left for college, the one thing like making me really want to stay in California was thinking about getting a pass holder.
Back.
I think I know what he got.
Look at mine.
Wow, I have that one too.
Are you guys pass holders?
Of course you do.
I don't know where it is though.
We are not.
Okay. I was gonna say that's commitment if you're a pass
holder. I ran down to Florida real quick and grabbed that. Oh, nice.
Oh, yeah. You just ran all the way here.
Yeah. Sorry I didn't say hi.
Stole that off my fridge. That's really rude of you. Yeah, yeah. Tinkerbell's on my fridge in the living room.
Hang on my fridge.
My fridge in the living room. My fridge in the kitchen.
Yeah, that's obviously the one for what? Was that 2019? Tinkerbell?
I think that was recent. Like, I think we just got that one.
Or maybe it was 2020.
I think that was like our apology sticker. That was like the.
Oh, okay.
Sorry for making you waste your money.
Sorry for, you paying for this annual pass for 6 months and you couldn't use it.
Yeah, my parents have some friends that live in Tampa, I think.
Mm-hmm.
And that was the one that. They have a new one, but they gave it to mom. So my mom just.
I don't put mine on my car because people have a habit of stealing them.
Yeah, I bet.
It was very easy to rip this thing off.
Well, also if you put it on your car too, like this one is damaged because my dad put tape on top of it. So I'm mad about it, but it's fine.
Are they magnets or stickers?
They're magnets. And what happened was. But last year when I moved apartments, we just taped my mini fridge closed with all the magnets still on top of it.
Ooh.
And he put the tape on top of Minnie Mouse. So when I went to take the tape off my mini fridge, it ripped it off, but it's fine.
Just, it's just Minnie. It's not Mickey.
It's one of the cutest ones too, because it's pink.
There's definitely a time where when I went to visit Kenzie and Izzy for the first time in January and we went to Disney World, I spent like half the trip thinking about, okay, how can I be a pass holder when I live out of state?
Well, I assume you can.
You can. It's just more money.
Yeah.
They make you pay more if you don't live in Florida.
Which I think is rigged because you're spending more money. If you're from out of states, they should give you a discount.
I think they do it because some people will buy annual passes. Like when they're planning their vacation, they'll buy an annual pass because they budget it as like cheaper to buy an annual pass than it is to like pay for your trip. And so I think they make it more for that. And also like that's part of the reason out of state annual pass holders can't have monthly payment plans. For their annual pass, you have to pay it in full, is because people would buy them for their trip and then go on their trip and then be like, ha, psych, I'm not paying the rest of these payments.
Oh, yeah.
So, because I'm not going back, like, I just booked it for, yeah. So, they don't let out-of-state pass holders have payment plans either, which is kind of, like, whack when you think about it, because, like, not everyone, but, I mean, people find ways around it. People will, I see a lot of times people just buy, like, Disney gift cards from, like, Target or, like, Sam's Club, because they get, like,
oh, yeah, yeah.
If you have, like, a Target Red card, and then you buy Disney gift cards with your Target Red credit card, you get like 5% back. People like have rigged the system to figure out how to like get discounts on stuff and whatever. And which, like,
it's
good for them.
It's gonna hurt Disney.
Exactly. Good for them. It's saving money. Like,
go for
Disney's
it.
Expensive. I'm not gonna pretend it's not. I freaking spent probably like $20 yesterday just like trying to eat enough to sustain myself. So, and I was only there for like 4 hours.
I mean, you have to eat the Disney snacks.
You do. Yeah,
it's tradition.
We went to Epcot, and it's food and wine right now. So, and they have at Epcot Food and Wine, they have Les Liés, like filet, like a little tiny piece of filet mignon that you can buy. It's like $9, but it's worth every cent because it's like $100 per person if you actually go to Les Liés and like get a meal. Like,
wow,
it's a very expensive restaurant in Canada. I want to go so bad, but like, I don't got that kind of money, and no one does either. Like, that's like, you know, one day in the distant future, when I have a significant other, maybe that's where they take me
to propose.
So if you're out there and you're watching,
there's your ideas.
Write it down, because she'll bring it up. She will.
Yes, she will. She'll be like, wait, you didn't watch that episode?
Did you not watch that episode?
You haven't watched every single second of the Lady Lorien show?
How?
Bye.
Sorry.
SMH. Bye. I can't. No, you got to watch every
single time for this.
Every episode of us having mental breakdowns. Oh. You need to see every second of it.
How we grow throughout the years.
Yeah.
Any final thoughts about Disney? Anything that you want to throw on the table while you have this chance? This is your one chance to speak to Disney themselves. They're watching. So if
they
they're watching. So if you had something,
we've already gotten a cease and desist. So
nope. I mean, we're probably gonna get it when we release this. But since they're watching, what do you say to them? If you have something to say to them, right?
I would say this: put a park in the middle of the country.
Yes.
You tell them.
Amen.
Specifically, if you want to go into Tennessee,
Tulsa, Oklahoma. Area.
That's too much competition with Dollywood.
No, Dollywood merge.
No, Dollywood is.
No, I don't think Dollywood would ever merge.
You can't just phase out Dolly. Oh, she just released a new banger.
I know she did.
I want to go to Dollywood so bad too. That's on the list for me.
We could have Disney World on the west side of Tennessee. I think that's good.
No. You already have Dollywood.
We can have two. What does Oklahoma have?
Frontier City.
We have Frontier City, which is dumb.
It's trash.
I don't know. Sorry, this is not
like,
relevant.
It's like less than Walmart Disney.
Did you guys know that up until 6 months ago, I didn't know where Oklahoma was located?
No, I know. I knew that. She thought we were like up by Canada or something.
Yeah. I don't know why.
Oh my gosh, did you not learn any geography in school?
Florida education system is not great.
Neither is Oklahoma.
Oh my goodness.
We're like last in everything.
Evidently, hey, Oklahoma's better than Florida.
You didn't know that Pee Wee Herman was Captain Rex on Star Tours, so.
Yeah,
until I did not. Like
an hour ago.
About an hour ago.
I thought, well, when you mentioned that, I thought you meant Captain Rex. And I was like,
no.
Captain Rex on Star Tours since when?
From Star Tours, the original Captain Rex, evidently.
R3X, DJ Rex now.
Yeah.
I would tell Disney, I would say, hey, where's my Big Hero 6 sequel?
Oh, facts.
True.
Why have we gotten two Frozen movies, which are bangers?
True.
Frozen 2 is a banger. I've seen it millions of times at this point. I love it.
Good.
But I need Big Hero 6 too, or whatever you want to call it.
Yeah.
Don't come at me with, oh, but there's a series.
Where is
the
Cars 4 release date?
No.
Literally.
No.
You tell them. Cause...
There's only two Cars movies.
Where's the Cars 3 release
date? There you go. Just erase Cars 2. Yeah, Afton, if you're hearing me, Cars 2 is trash.
Where is the Cars 2 re-release where it's completely redone into a better movie?
Make a better movie.
There you go.
Pixar.
Afton is punching the air right now.
Yes.
As she should.
Well, those are all
for Afton. We love her.
I know. Maybe next time we can have Afton on too and we could do a Disney part 2.
That would be awesome.
Okay.
We'll and then she could tell you why Disneyland is better than Disney World too.
Ooh, exactly. Yeah.
It's true.
Exactly.
I'm already outnumbered. I don't know. No, it's okay.
Just accept it.
So is Hunter, is Disneyland your favorite or is World your favorite? It is.
The only thing that Disney World has over Disneyland is Flight of Passage.
Mm. And why is Disneyland your favorite?
I can live without Everest.
He's still not answering my question.
I like
I'm gonna remember this. I'm gonna remember this. Don't worry.
Okay, are you gonna remember where Oklahoma is?
No.
Okay.
That one I can't.
It's kind of rude, but I like Disneyland the most because you can do everything in a day.
That's true.
It's not so spread out.
But if you guys travel all the way to California to go,
we have family in California.
Oh, okay. So you go for.
Does Disney World have Avengers Campus? Nope.
Ooh.
Which we need to do. That's the next thing on our list to do.
I'm going on Monday. I'm sorry.
Are you really?
Yes.
Shut up.
Sorry, the theme park that has my heart has
Universal.
Yeah.
Has Harry Potter?
Has
no
Marvel rights, so Harry we Potter, can't. Ugh.
Yeah, but those Marvel rights, they aren't MCU.
Hulk is literally one of the best rides ever.
Mm-hmm. I haven't been on it.
I wanted to puke.
Well, that sounds like you problem, Hunter.
It is.
Hulk is one of the best rides.
I'd love to go on it.
They make you take everything out of your pockets and put in a locker.
Because people
go upside down.
And it goes upside down and it goes over guests. And somebody lost an eye on Dueling Dragons because people didn't take stuff out of their pocket.
A fake eye?
No, like something hit. So Dueling Dragons, which doesn't exist anymore, but it was at Islands of Adventure at Universal Studios. It used to have dueling coasters. And there was like a loop part where like the coasters literally went like this and like your feet were going like this across from somebody else. Anyways, they like crossed over each other a lot. They were dueling. And before they had metal detectors, people would not take stuff out of their pockets and then stuff would fly out of their pockets. And then one day somebody got hit in the face with something and they lost their eye from it. And now that's why there's metal detectors at Hulk, Velocicoaster, and Rip Ride Rocket.
Maybe what we've learned from this is that Disney.
Don't try to take your stuff on rides. You're not supposed to.
Well, hopefully I'll get to go on Velocicoaster in September.
What we learned from this is
Velocicoaster is a sore subject for me right now.
Universal has dangerous rides.
Yeah. I'm here for
better a time ride.
And a long
in
time.
In the ghetto.
Hey. Universal. Ooh,
the ghetto.
Is not the ghetto. I'm not all here. Of
that last 5 minutes is going to be cut out because it was talking about Universal and not Disney.
But we're but we're slandering them.
Yeah.
So
we're saying Disney.
Okay.
Superior.
Well, I'm gonna need y'all to stop because that's
maybe
my
you should have worked at Disney.
Your employers.
Like, the last thing I need is to come into work and have my supervisor be like, "Hey, Mackenzie, I need to talk to you." I come in the office and they're playing. A video
this?
Where my friends are roasting my job.
So that's why we don't show this part of the video.
Hey, you can roast my job. I don't care.
I'll figure it out. I'll decide fair. Later in the future. So,
anyways, if my besties, my supervisors are watching this, love you guys. You know, we're a great company.
Well, thank you so much for coming on for the first time. I'm sure we'll have you again for part 2 and we'll have after.
Okay. That'll be
we have
fun.
To buffer some episodes here. We can't have Hunter back on because we can't let him have the power of
he's the most guest star. The understudies.
I'm gonna end up in her room with the camera too.
He's just in the background standing trying to make that cameo. Will All right, well, thank you guys so much for listening and watching. Obviously you guys love love Disney if you love Star Wars. If you don't love Disney and you love Star Wars, you're wrong. So you should I hope you guys don't come for me. I hope you guys liked this episode. I know we had a lot of fun filming it. If you guys want to see a part two, whether you like it or not, there's gonna be a part two. But let us know what your favorite ride is or park.
Star Tours
inside Disney World. Yeah, you comment that down below, Hunter.
Hunter.
Bring back Alien Encounter. Bring it back.
No, okay. They need to put something better there.
They could put Alien Encounter, but make it Alien because they have Fox rights now.
Ooh, true.
Where's my check?
That's right.
Yeah, don't be giving those ideas away for free.
Yeah. Exactly.
No. As long as they do it, I don't care. Make it happen.
Make it happen. Expect a check in the mail.
All right. Josh, tomorrow, if you're listening, make it happen.
Josh, please.
There you go.
Take over as CEO, please. I need you to take over.
We need you.
Yeah, for real. Next.
Need you next.
Alrighty. Thank you guys so much for listening. Our social medias are down below if you guys want to follow that. If you haven't already, make sure to like and subscribe. If you are listening on Apple Podcasts or on Spotify, leave Spotify for a second and go to Apple Podcasts and leave us a review, because they mean a lot for us. And we haven't had one for a little bit, and it would make us happy. So please do that. And we will see you guys in 2 weeks.
Bye.